Is this the best battery you can get for your AEP? Let's find out. So this battery comes in a package like this. It's from Nupro. It has 550 milliamps capacity and 20C, so it should be more than enough for a stock AEP. When you get this box with a battery, it's just a plastic bag with a battery and a manual and some information inside. Don't need that. So the battery looks like this. This is my second one. I have this one, so this is a spare battery. I haven't used this in a couple of years. As you can see, it's little bit puffed, but nothing big. And the thing with this battery is that they don't come with the arrow on the front like the TN batteries and other batteries do. So you need to figure out which side it's the positive and which side is negative. And then you need to create an arrow, so it's easier to put the right side down. The gun I have used is a Tokumarui high kappa gun. And just to be sure, you see that the battery fits, even with the slide. Back on. Of course, you will get higher RPMs with these lipo batteries compared to the stock ones. TM AEPs don't come with a battery. The downside of this battery having a higher RPM is that when you are using your standard 29 rounds or 30 rounds magazines, you will have a hard time feeding all the BBs on full auto. But this 100 round magazine manage just fine to feed those rounds. So you need to shoot single with these kinds of magazines. Okay, so to make it easier for you to put the batteries in the right way, you will see the label like that. You will see a red dot on one of the sides. And if I flip it over, you will see the one I created the arrow on, pointing that way. So you need to create an arrow on your battery with the label to the left. Okay. The way I did that, I tried with a marker first, but that just rubbed off. So I used a small screwdriver and just carved it away a little bit of material to create an arrow. It's not more to it than that. I have used this battery for a couple of years. Haven't had any problems. It will, if you use your AEP as a sidearm, it will hold a whole day. So the capacity is quite good. If you have two batteries, a spare one, you probably won't have any problems. The way to charge these batteries can be a little bit tricky, because it only has this balance lead and a proprietary connector which fits in the gun. So you can either use a battery charger like this, which has a 2S balance plug and a 3S balance plug, which can only charge from the balance plug, or you can create a balance lead that looks something like this. This lead is not for this battery, but for a body battery, the internal battery from to my SSG. I can link a video in the top and you can see how I made this balance lead. It's in the end of the video. But basically, this one with the three connectors will go to the balance plug. This will go into the charger, and this will go into the balance plug on the charger. And then you can just charge it like you normally would. And now I will show you a little bit of footage from the chrono, and you will see how this compare on Fallout 2 compared to this. That's basically it for this video. If you found this helpful at all, please consider to subscribe and like this video. And you can comment below if there are something you are wondering about or anything at all.